क्लास 9 बायोलॉजी। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू द सेम चैप्टर, दैट इज 7th चैप्टर, रेस्पिरेशन इन प्लांट्स। इन दिस चैप्टर टुडे वी विल डिस्कस कंपैरिजन बिटवीन द respiration and photosynthesis. Means here we will compare respiration with photosynthesis because both of these processes are biological processes, biochemical processes that are occurring inside the living body. If we talk about respiration takes place both in animals and plants, but photosynthesis is only occurs inside the plant. The plant must be green in color, or the parts of the plant which are green in color. So see this chemical equation. Here carbon dioxide and water are the two reactants, and glucose and oxygen are the products. This reaction completes in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. So this is the reaction of photosynthesis. So what is photosynthesis? All green plants carry out a process in which carbon dioxide and water react with each other in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll to produce food, that is glucose and oxygen. So glucose and oxygen are the two products. Here oxygen released into the atmosphere, that's why plants are considered as the air purifier, because plants take in carbon dioxide and release oxygen. When we talk this chemical equation from left to right, this is photosynthesis. But when we move reverse, that is from right to left, it is known as respiration, because in respiration food is broken down in the presence of oxygen to release water, carbon dioxide and energy. So in photosynthesis, that is from left to right, solar energy or energy is consumed. We had discussed in metabolic activities anabolic and catabolic. So here first one, photosynthesis, energy is utilized, is called anabolic or photosynthesis. Here when we move in reverse direction, this glucose undergoes oxidation to release carbon dioxide, water, energy. So here energy released, and energy is released during the process during respiration, and respiration is called destructive process or energy releasing process. So see the book, what is written. In many respects, respiration and photosynthesis in plant are distinctly opposite process, because reactants and products are just different. One is energy consuming process, another is the energy releasing process. The requirements of one are the products of the other, and therefore they are complementary to each other. This is the reason why we cannot conduct an experiment on plant respiration during daytime. A big question here: why it is difficult to demonstrate respiration in plants during the daytime. Here one big question rises. Make the question in the book, why it is difficult to demonstrate respiration in plant during the time. So this is the question. So see here, plant A, and this is the plant B. There are two plants, plants A and plant B. Here it is the daytime, this is the night. So it is completely clear during night time plant taking oxygen from the atmosphere during the night time and release carbon dioxide. During night, plant take in oxygen from the atmosphere and release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. But during the daytime, plants take in carbon dioxide and release oxygen. If during the daytime plant take in carbon dioxide and release oxygen, that means plant do not carry out respiration during the daytime. So here one question arises, what is the source of oxygen for respiration during the daytime? So see here, when photosynthesis takes place, oxygen is one of the byproducts in plants during the daytime. So whatever the oxygen needed by the plants for respiration is their own products. Initially they utilize that oxygen, and most of the oxygen released into the atmosphere. Means during daytime oxygen utilized in the process of respiration is their own product. That's why it is difficult to demonstrate respiration in plants during daytime. Clear all of you? Here some points given to differentiate photosynthesis and respiration. Occurs only in the presence of chlorophyll. Occurs in all living cell. Occurs only in the presence of light. Occurs all the time, because respiration is a continuous process from the birth to death of any living organism. Use carbon dioxide and water, use glucose and oxygen. Oxygen release as an end product, carbon dioxide release as an end product. In photosynthesis, light energy is converted into chemical energy, and in respiration, chemical energy is partly converted into heat energy and partly into useful energy for various activity. Photosynthesis result in gain in weight, and respiration result in loss in weight. Here food is manufactured, that is constructive. Here food is broken down, oxidized, so it's destructive. So it is better to learn the overall chemical reaction, to learn all the difference between photosynthesis and respiration. Clear all of you? Next point. Respiration in plant compared with respiration in animal. Already we have discussed. In plants, there is no gaseous transport. The respiratory gases simply diffuse in and out by cell to cell diffusion. Animals, the blood transport respiratory gas. Means animal, we have one system called circulatory system, and this circulatory system means to transport various substance in the body. But plant do not have any circulatory system, so whatever the gaseous exchange takes place, that is only by the method of simple diffusion. And if it is inside the plant body, then it is cell to cell diffusion. Second, one of the end products of anaerobic respiration in plants is ethanol or ethyl alcohol, but in animal it is lactic acid. Means when the animals having deficient or no supply of oxygen, at that time the glucose undergo incomplete oxidation to produce lactic acid. In plant, the process produce little heat as compared to animals. So in animals, more heat is released to keep the body warm. So this is the end of the chapter. Revise the chapter properly, and whatever the question will give in the homework, must do that, because soon you have online mock test in this month only. Okay, have a good day. Bye all of you.